for our paramour ball. Thank you for our constituents. And I would also say a special thank you for my mom. Please give us wisdom and strength and courage to do what's right for our city. Help us to keep the city moving forward and help us to do a great job in all here. Thank you.
Amen. Let allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Your Honor.
That's great.
those rooms are all involved in. I think I know that you've got Nellie Sims, you've got Leonard Sims, you've got all of those, everybody, let's see.
Insane.
This is a proclamation by the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Representative Richard Bennett, congratulating Ms. Alice Veronica Payne Carrillo on the occasion of her 90th birthday. Whereas on this day, February, Ms. Alice Veronica Payne Carrillo of Long Beach, Mississippi, celebrates her 90th birthday. And whereas she was born in 1922 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, to the loving father, Leonard Paul Capania of Gulfport, Mississippi, and a loving mother, Nellie Elizabeth Porta, Pittsburgh. And whereas, from the tender age of two, she was raised on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, along with her six brothers, five of whom served in the United States Armed Forces, and spent the majority of her life as a resident of Long Beach, Mississippi. Whereas after graduating from St. Francis DeSales School in Gulfport, Mississippi, she decided to volunteer her services to this country during World War II as a civilian by working for the Ration Board and Supply Office at the Gulfport Army Airfield. And whereas in 1946, she married the love of her life, United States Army Lieutenant Paul Joseph Carrillo, who was born in Long Beach, Mississippi. And to this blessed union, eight children were born. Whereas his dedicated mother and loving wife was also who used her skills as a seamstress to operate a drapery making business out of her home and helped chart the St. Thomas Mothers Club, which later became the Cornwall Association of Long Beach. And she remained a member for over 25 years, whereas an active member of the Cornwall Association as a member of the Royal Court raised tens of thousands of dollars to support the St. Thomas schools and local charities. Whereas Ms. Carrillo has been and continues to be an inspiration to all who know her, especially her seven surviving children, 17 grandchildren, 17 great-grandchildren, and where it is the policy of the House of Representatives to commend the lives and legacies of Mississippians who have created loving homes and families that improve the quality of this state's communities. Now, therefore, on behalf of the House of Representatives of the state of Mississippi, we do hereby commend the life of Ms. Alice Veronica Payne Carrillo and congratulate her upon celebrating her 90th birthday.
Bring that up when we get to the planning board.
Hearing next. Do y'all have any questions?
No. Mayor, I just want to let you know, I'm out there in Durban, and it's definitely in need of renewal.
All right. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I'll see you. Proof minutes, Mayor Moore.
Where are we going?
Oh, Shane, this is Smith. Shane Smith. Yeah, Tom and Shane.
I don't know why I'm here. I have Mary Ann Baird, who's been funded by me since forever. I see she's a little bit further than I'm on now. But I try to do a good business out here. I sell used cars. And I have been so scared, even calling and trying to help clean up the property, because she has called along me about a dozen times in the last 2 years. Right along here, I'm already looking for a truck. I've been arrested for disturbing the peace, this oil will pop up. I'm like, I'm gonna just try to sell it.
Yes, sir.
So you have to do what they're telling you.
Yeah, you know what to do about that.
And she said, I got four some concrete. Now, we did it.
Yeah, that's just the only issue, yeah.
Right, that is the problem. And then I also had the fire inspector, I think, Greg or something was his name.
Yeah.
I just called him and that. And when all the violations, my house is triggered, I've got one switchblade cover. And my fire extinguisher is expired. But I'll take that because it was a city fire extinguisher, so they'll expect that to do that.
Okay.
Well, we're good about this towards the end of the meeting.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry.
Next, Mayor Moore called, make everything through minutes.
Seven. Try to keep it a family type event without
overly promoting the alcohol. Would you consider asking Budweiser to